Okay, everybody. So, I am back, hopefully consistently. And if I don't snap it, then that means I'm also not reading my Bible, which is not good for me either. Here is the week. This week is patience. I have the series, scriptures, and this is what's going to be every day's topic. So the scripture for the week is from Ecclesiastes 7, 7 through 9. Extortion turns wise people into fools, and bribes corrupt the heart. Finishing is better than starting. Patience is better than pride. Control your temper, for anger labels you a fool. Today's theme is what the Bible says about patience. And then let me put up the graphics for today. I'm going to try something different this week. I have two songs that I'm going to play this week. One is today and one is tomorrow. If I think of more, I'll add them. But I'm going to play more than just like a 30-second thing. This is going to be the whole song. This song is called In His Time. I think it's kind of an old like hymn kind of a song, so I couldn't find it who was singing it. I am going to read from 1 Corinthians and Proverbs. So this will be 1 Corinthians 13, 4 through 5. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Next is Proverbs 14:29.
A patient man or woman has great understanding, but a quick-tempered man or woman displays folly.
Folly is a lack of good sense. I like that. Foolishness. This will be a good week for me. I think patience is always something that's good to just remember and to practice and to kind of... I made a note here in my Bible. Oops, it's back in 1 Corinthians 1. It said, self-control is a sign of maturity. And I think that the hardest thing to do, at least for me, once I became a parent... was recognizing that a 3-year-old, Alexander, doesn't really get, he's not really in a hurry, you know? Like, for me, if, say, I'm getting ready to make dinner, and I'm chopping, and I'm peeling, and I'm prepping a whole bunch of things, I see the end game. I see I need to have all this stuff done, and then I still have to put it in the pot, and then I still have to do the oven, and yada, yada, yada. Whereas he is sort of just in the moment, so he's not really thinking that far ahead, and he just is going, it's not really that he's going slow, he's just going at a comfortable pace for him. And so it's hard for me, it's just hard for me to remember that like he's not trying to slow me down, you know. I think kids, you know, they are the ones who'll stop and notice a butterfly, or they say stop and smell the roses. So that's kind of been something that is hard for me, and I'm sure most of us, you know, once you become a parent, is kind of trying to slow down. One thing one of my favorite bloggers says is that we don't, as parents, we don't always feel patient, but because we are mature, hopefully, we can choose to act patient. So a couple of things that you can do today. One is write down the words slow down where you will see them. Something else you can do is what I just said is act patient, even if you don't feel patient. And the last one is to thank God for his forgiveness and his patience with you. That's it. I've got the rest of the week planned out, and hopefully I'll be back on tomorrow with day 2.